दिस टर्म इज कॉल्ड मैग्नेटिक इंटेंसिटी, मैग्नेटिक इंटेंसिटी, दिस इज कॉल्ड मैग्नेटिक इंटेंसिटी एंड इट इज डिनोटेड बाय एच. नोटेशन यूज फॉर दिस इज एच. एच इज इक्वल टू एन आई. नाउ टेक अ केस व्हेन वेयर वी प्लेस अ मटीरियल इनसाइड द सोलेनाइड. दिस इज अ सोलेनाइड विद अ मटीरियल. इट कैन बी एनी मटीरियल. द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मटीरियल विल चेंज the in this space where the material is there. Earlier this was the magnetic field, but now it will change and it will become b new b, which will be there in presence of the material, plus b dash. Now this b dash is dependent on the current, that is h is dependent on I. It is dependent on magnetic intensity in the coil and also the type of material. And we call this as intensity of magnetization. This is intensity of magnetization. Some books write it as I, some books write it as M. Let us use it as I. M is then equal to H. This is susceptibility, means susceptibility of material to magnetization. Susceptibility of the material to magnetization. So M is equal to X. And H is what? H is equal to Ni. And here when we place it, we write it as B is equal to B0 plus mu 0 M. It will be mu 0 times M. So the equation becomes like this. And if we write the values further, B becomes B0 plus mu 0 susceptibility times the magnetic intensity. And what was B0? B0 was mu 0 H plus mu 0 susceptibility times the magnetic intensity. It becomes mu 0 H, we take common, 1 plus susceptibility. This term is also called relative permeability. This is called relative permeability of the material. So we will write as magnetic field inside the solenoid when this material is placed becomes equal to mu 0 mu r, this is mu r, into h. Mu 0 into mu r becomes mu, the permeability of the material. So when there is a material, we write as B is equal to mu 0 mu h. B is mu h. Mu is the permeability of the material, and when there is no material, B is equal to mu 0 h. H is equal to Ni. I hope this makes it clear about the relationship between magnetization and magnetic intensity. Now let us come to the hysteresis loop. Now we will cover the hysteresis loop part. In this we plot magnetization, that is M, magnetization, we can call it by M, or we use, some books use I, so it can be M or I. And on the x-axis we plot we write magnetic intensity. We know magnetic intensity is H is equal to Ni. Suppose we take a coil and we pass current in this direction, and there is a ferromagnetic material inside the solenoid, ferromagnetic material is there. Now we should know the property of ferromagnetic material before we proceed. In ferromagnetic material, we know there are domains, different domains are there in the material. If we draw it like this, and domains have their own alignment, they have their individual magnetic moments, but these are randomly organized, they are random. So the net magnetic field inside the ferromagnetic material in absence of any external field is zero, but when there is an external magnetic field, these domains align in a particular direction and they produce a magnetic field. Now this, in this case, we pass the current, and when the current is zero, there is no magnetization, but when the current is passed and the intensity of current is increased, H is increasing, the magnetization increases initially like this, but it finally dips to the saturation level. This is the maximum magnetization which can happen, M maximum, and it is called saturation point. Saturation point. This is saturation point. Now, having reached the saturation point, we now reverse the flow. We start first decreasing the flow of current. Suppose the current has reached level, I say 10 amperes was there, though it's a very high current, still let us take this example, 10 amperes, we'll start reducing it. This was H0 representing the maximum value. We start reducing the, initially we were increasing, now we are reducing. So the curve will not come back in this path. Why it doesn't come back in this path is simply because that the domains of the ferromagnetic material, they do not get randomized when you start reducing it. As they were being aligned, when the current was increasing, the de-alignment, if I use that word, doesn't take place in that proportion. It retains certain alignment even when we reduce the current back to zero. We reduce the current back to zero, some domains retain their alignment, which gives it magnetization. So the path followed is this and not the original path. So it comes back with by this path, and this is called retentivity. This is called retentivity. Retentivity is the word used for this retention of the magnetization when the current has been brought to zero. Now in this quadrant, when we come, the same coil, the same material, but now we start passing, earlier we were flowing current in this direction, now the current is flowing in this direction. We reverse the current, and when the current is reversed, the demagnetization takes place, and at certain point when value becomes this much, which is called coercive magnetic intensity, this is coercivity or the coercive magnetic intensity, then this magnetization becomes zero. Now at a particular current in the opposite direction, we have brought the material back to the initial position. This magnetization here is zero, but we needed current for doing that. This is called the coercivity. Now when we further increase the current in this direction, again the magnetization starts taking place, but this time if it was magnetization in this direction, say this was north, this was south, now the magnetization happens in this direction, in the opposite direction, and a point comes when again we reach the saturation point, and this value of H at saturation point is minus H0. We have reached the reverse, the negative of the maximum magnetization, when the current is being flowing in the opposite direction. Now when we start reducing the current in the opposite direction, again the alignment starts breaking, but alignment doesn't break in the way it was being formed. So because alignment doesn't fully breaks, there is a certain retention. Again we get the same situation, current has been brought to zero, but there remains certain magnetization, which is again retentivity in the other direction. Now we go back to the same direction, original direction, we start flowing the current. Here current was zero, but magnetization was still retained by it. Now we start flowing current in the original direction, which we take it as a positive direction. Now it starts getting demagnetized. They were aligned in a particular direction. Now this alignment has broken, and this is again the coercive force which you have applied. Now if we keep on flowing current in this direction further, it meets at this point. So this is the hysteresis loop. It follows this path, the magnetization and demagnetization. If we call it A, if we call it B, C, D, E, and F. This A, B, C, D, E, and F to A, they represent the hysteresis loop. Hysteresis loop. And the area of this loop, the area of this loop represents thermal energy. The energy wasted in magnetization and demagnetization is the thermal energy. Thermal energy. So this is it. I hope you found it useful. Thank you.